name is Olena. I'm from Ukraine, but today I represent Brno University of Technology in Czech Republic. And today I would like to discuss with you my research about increasing students' motivation by using virtual learning environments based on the gamification mechanics. So a few words about the motivation behind this research. The problem of low students' interest in, and engagement is really crucial nowadays in the educational systems. We've heard today already several more articles about that. And we really need to think how to improve the motivation, not only at the beginning of the process, but also to help students to keep up a higher motivational level during all the educational process. And recently, in various researches where motivation and engagement of persons are included, gamification mechanics are highly considered. And just to give you a bigger idea of my research, this article is only a first step. And later on, I'm creating personalized gamified programming course with dynamic difficulty adjustments based on the student's skills level, which would be retrieved from multimodal learning analysis. So what is gamification? There actually exist several different definitions, but the most popular one comes from Sebastian Witterding, and he says that this is a use of game elements characteristics in non-games environments. Such elements might be points, badges, progress bars, meaningful stories, profile development, and actually all educational system might be considered as already gamified when we consider grade as points and courses as levels which student has to pass in order to achieve the final goal. But important thing here is not to make them think that all educational process is just a game. It is still an education, but we can enhance it using some gamification mechanics. So about my experiment in this research. It was conducted while teaching web development course for IT bachelor students in Brno University of Technology. You can see some basic info about them, average age, and year of bachelor students. And the first task for them was to select, we gave them complete freedom if they want to do a regular assignment for programming course or gamified one. And majority of students selected gamified assignment and shown high enthusiasm and interest in our new task. And then we gave them a questionnaire asking why they selected gamified task. Most of them told that it is just more fun because they have some game elements, which is obvious. But the second group of answer is actually interesting for us. Most of students thought that gamified assignment should be easier than normal one just because it is kind of a game. But actually, in these gamified tasks, we managed to give them more information because it was well structured, automatically checked for all levels, and all the necessary information was just stripped out of the task. So they felt like it was easier, though we managed to give them more information in this assignment. Here is actually a screenshot of this gamified assignment. The narrative was to eliminate all bombs from the field by marking them with the help of these white flags. And to put a flag, they had to complete some part of jQuery code. This actually assignment was aimed to teach some jQuery basics. Here they had some theory, some hints, and what they actually need to achieve. And whenever they put some code in here, it was checked automatically, and if it was correct, they were starting the next level. And here they had kind of progress bar. Here it says how many levels they still need to complete in order to finish all assignment. Just basic structure, JSON structure of each level. It is super easy to add new levels to this assignment just by creating new JSON blocks of code. And all this assignment is JavaScript based and open source. After students finish the assignment, we ask them to evaluate it. And results were really nice. For example, we had 76 students participating in this assignment. And you can see that majority of them actually really loved our idea, told them that they were really engaged by it. And not a single student disliked it. So everyone was really satisfied with the task. And we also asked them how likely would they select these kinds of tasks for the next assignments. And again, you can see that results, like students really like this kind of tasks. We already have some ideas how to extend this assignment. adding variable adaptive difficulty, which I have mentioned before, then integrating all course assignments into this huge gamified platform and not having only one assignment, adding social influence drive, for example, creating some leaderboards, scoreboards, and then grouping students by their level and using advanced learning dashboards. And then actually the next step in this research is applying multidimensional learning analytics in order to get students' current skills level. Why do we need this? Why do we need to get skill levels and apply dynamic difficulty in order to help students to keep up with the flow state? This is the state in which they feel like it is the most interesting part. Here in the illustration, when skills level get higher, we also need to get the challenges higher in order to keep them interested. But learning curve is different for every person. So we need to know how skilled currently the student is in order to modify difficulty accordingly. And we also had this question in our questionnaire, if they would like to have more hints or documentation, so to make it easier or more difficult. And you can see that the results are divided evenly in thirds, so really for everyone the difficulty level felt like a different one. And just some things to discuss for further steps. If teacher role isn't decreased with such kind of automatically checked assignments, or if game isn't actually a distraction because maybe not everyone likes playing games, and also if assignments with a variable difficulty can lead to honest evaluation if we give students different difficulty tasks. So these are just some questions which we are going to find out in the next step of our research.